One of the first types of linear equations that you'll learn how to solve are called one-step linear equations. These are a good introduction into how to solve linear equations. They're not the most difficult type of exercises, but they are very, very popular. So let's take a look at how we solve one-step linear equations. The reason they call them one-step equations is they literally take one step to solve to get your answer to solve for x or whatever your variable is. And the step that you'll be taking is either the using the addition property or the multiplication property. And the reason or the way that you know which property to use is you're going to be doing the opposite of whatever is done to x. And the mathematical word for this is the inverse operation. So for example, if x is being added by something, we're going to subtract. Or if it's multiplied, we're going to divide. We're always going to do the opposite of whatever is done to our variable. And that's what's going to help us solve for x. So let's look at a few examples. So here we go. First example, they want us to solve the equation 2x equals 12. And when they say solve, what they mean is isolate the x, get the x by itself. Well, the x is being multiplied by 2. So I want to solve for x in one step. And since x is multiplied by 2, I'm going to divide by 2. And the reason that's a good idea is the times 2 and divide by 2 will negate each other, it will cancel each other, and then we would just have x by itself on the left-hand side. But here's where the multiplication or addition properties are going to come in. If you're going to multiply or divide the left side by a certain number, you need to do the same thing to the right-hand side. So since we divided the left side by 2, we're also going to divide the right side by 2. And 12 divided by 2 is 6. So 6 would be our final answer. This would be the solution to this linear equation. Now, one other way to say this is instead of 2x equals 12, instead of dividing or using that language, you could easily say multiply by a half. And that has the same effect. Multiplying by a half is like dividing by 2. 2 times a half is 1. And so we get x equals 12 times a half, which is 6, which is the same answer as what we have here. Let's try another one. Let's say we have the equation 4 equals negative 7 plus y. I'd like to isolate the y. I'd like to solve for y. Right now, I have an extra negative 7 on the right-hand side that I don't want. This is like subtracting 7 that I don't want on the right-hand side. So the opposite of that would be to add 7 to the right-hand side. But remember the addition property. If you add 7 to the right to keep this equality maintained right here, you also have to add 7 to the left so that everything stays balanced. Minus 7 and plus 7, they cancel. And so we get 11, 4 plus 7, 11 equals y. Or obviously, you could say y equals 11. The order in which you write the sides doesn't matter. So there's our solution to this equation. And you can check your answer by replacing y with 11. Negative 7 plus 11 is in fact 4. So that is the right answer. All right, last example. 10m equals 5. Well, we're going to look to see what's being done to m, and we're going to do the opposite. Well, m is being multiplied by 10. So we are going to divide by 10. And what's nice about that, the reason that works well, is that would make the tens cancel. Times 10 and divide by 10 cancel each other. You would just get an m equal to 5 over 10. And make sure we're dividing both sides by 10. So 5 over 10, that's a fraction, which is okay. That's totally fine. And matter of fact, that fraction will reduce to 1/2. So our solution would be m equals a half. And just like before, we can go back and check our answer. If we think 1/2 is our solution for m, let's go back to the white equation, 10m equals 5. 10 times a half is 5. So that is in fact the correct solution. So just remember for these one-step equations, basically you're just going to do the opposite of whatever is done to x. It should only take you one step to solve for your variable.